Hello and welcome to this video where we look at the website's dashboard in NewsWhip Analytics. We'll review what it is and how to use it. The website's dashboard allows you to search historical engagement data for one or many specific sites. This can be used to track your own data or compare yourself to competitors, either with overall performance or filtered by certain topics over different time periods. I'll start a new dashboard. Now I can choose any website, but realistically this dashboard is designed and used for some sort of news publisher. You can enter a brand website or similar, but it might be quite limited for information. I will use Tesla as an example to show this. As you can see, it has some information, but it won't provide interaction data like Google Analytics or similar. I'll start with some well-known big hitters. I'll add the BBC, Al Jazeera. I'm also trying to remember here the international news channels you get in a hotel room television. Okay, one small tip at this time is to double check the URL in a browser, as some newspapers have similar names. Okay, we're ready to go. If we created this dashboard, it would compare the output of all these websites. However, I could also choose to filter it with a keyword for a more specific breakdown. This is where I could add Tesla, or you could go with your own brand, company, or client. In this case, I'll just add Qatar to get a breakdown of the current ongoing FIFA World Cup. Here we can see the usual tables breaking down total and average interactions. We can also see in the chart that the numbers are rising later into the month when the tournament started. Now, someone from CNBC may spot that they've only published a few articles in comparison to others, but there is still a high average interaction for them all. If we move to the leaderboard, we can see who has written these articles. Again, you can use this to find the main journalists for each website and the topic you filtered, and also generally perhaps the quality of their output based on interactions. I'll create a new dashboard focused on the more popular use case, which is internal and external benchmarking. I'll select The Guardian, which is a UK newspaper. I won't add any filters and I'll also name the dashboard. Here's the general website stats for the past week. And now with the leaderboard, this can be used to compare all your offers internally to see who is getting good interactions, or perhaps to quickly confirm how many articles they've written. And now we'll move on to the last tab, which produces an excellent report. This can be immediately shared and also scheduled, so it automatically appears in the inbox of your team. The report provides an easily digestible overview of a website, including metrics, top articles, and social media performance. It works standalone, but also seamlessly syncs with some external benchmarking. I'm going to quickly edit this dashboard now to add some competitors. Again, here is a good example of double checking the name or URL as I struggle with the Daily Mail. I'll rename the dashboard and create it with these new additions. Again, we can see these compared on the overview and leaderboard tabs, but I really want to jump back into the report and show how they compare. As you can see, our beautiful report now has comparative data with The Guardian selected as the main source. I now have a best practice suggestion. Use websites dashboards for benchmarking and white space analysis. These dashboards are best utilized by publishers. It is an excellent tool for benchmarking internally and externally, and it can also provide a valuable insight into white space opportunities. Have you had a bad week for engagement numbers? Well, why not consolidate yourself by seeing if your competitors also suffered? Are you not sure where to begin on your next piece? Well, maybe you can spot a seasonal topic or trend with high average engagement, but with a low article count amongst your competitors. Thanks for watching.